subscribe to the channel and leave a like on this video. You can also follow Solitaire ASMR on Instagram for behind the scenes content. I won't be playing with the Texas deck tonight because, as you can see, I have an iPad with Spider Solitaire downloaded on it. I actually just downloaded this app, but I'm excited to play a few games and see how it goes. I know a lot of you have been requesting Spider Solitaire, and I do love playing Spider Solitaire, but shuffling the cards physically together is so labor-intensive. It takes forever, and just getting them organized for a game takes longer than actually playing the game. So now that I have an iPad, which I borrowed from my sister, this is a much easier way to play Spider Solitaire, and I hope you can enjoy it just the same. Now, if you're not familiar with Spider Solitaire, that's okay. Basically, you are just trying to stack all of the cards in a row, numerically, in the same suit. So it's a bit different than traditional solitaire, where you are alternating colors. I mean, obviously in this version of Spider Solitaire, this is the easiest version. We only have one suit to play with. So I think you'll notice that this game might go by pretty quickly. But even when you're playing other versions of Spider Solitaire, more advanced versions, you're always trying to get king through ace in the same suit. So once I drop this ace on the two, you can see that it sorts that pile over here. So you're trying to do that with all of the cards in your deck. You'll see how it gets a bit trickier when you play the more advanced versions with two suits, and then ultimately four suits. This is what I've played on the channel in the past. So, if you've seen those Spider Solitaire videos, which I used physical cards to play, then you know just how challenging it can be. Okay. This 5-4-3 is lighting up. I don't know what that means. Oh, yeah, I can play it on the 6. Okay, so I guess it can give me some hints if I need it. I might want to turn off that feature, though. So, I just uncovered my first open spot. Just like in, in normal, traditional solitaire, you can only put kings in the open spot. But actually, with Spider Solitaire, you can play any card in those open spots. I do always think that kings are still best to play, unless you really want to find out what's beneath a different stack. Okay, so it looks like we have run out of options with the cards that we have here. I'm guessing this is going to light up soon to suggest that that's the only move we can make next. Yeah, exactly. There we go. So now you can see that it starts to get a little bit more tricky because the 7 landed on top of the 3. And so I cannot move this 9 onto that 10. Before I do that, I have to move this 7 onto an 8. And then that becomes available again. So now I can move the 9 to the 10, the 10 to the jack, and we can continue playing. That's the part that gets especially tricky when you're playing with multiple suits. We don't have any aces right now. Sound effects every time. looks like maybe we've run out of options again. There's a jack. Queen. There's an ace. Let's put the ace there. There's a 10 right there. We could just play this ace on the 2. There we go. And then if we find a 10 that I could play this on, we can then put it on the jack. Maybe we'll do, since we have so many open spots to work with, we really have the luxury of just moving cards around. Halfway done, win any deal to finish. I don't know what that means. I wonder if I'm earning points as I play. I feel like all of these apps, there's always some kind of point system. Never really been a big fan of this. Oh. I guess I should turn off my notifications. Oh, there we go. That was my friend Matt. We've just been catching up. Let's see. I guess maybe. Oh, yes. I can turn on my focus, can't I? Do not disturb. Solitaire, you have to have all of those open spots filled before you can deal another round of cards. Let's see, there's a 4. We have so many aces all of a sudden. Jack. Stack right now. No, I'm missing a 2. There's a 2. There we go. Looks like we're just about finished. A sloppy game right now because it really is quite easy to win Spider Solitaire when you're playing with only one suit. Let's get that one out of the way. collection. New title earned, hobbyist. Okay. New deal. Now maybe we want to try playing with two suits. There we go. Oh wow. We could even play with three. I never knew that was an option. Looks like we can also customize our background. I kind of like the traditional green though. Maybe we'll mix it up just for a game. The setting will not take effect until the next game. Okay. Custom card face. Oh, look at this. So many options. I don't know, I kind of like the traditional card face. Maybe I'll play this on live next time and we can choose, we can customize our settings. Yeah, I'll stick with the traditional card face for now. Custom card pack, oh wow. This is a bit overwhelming actually. I could play with cats. Okay, sorry, I'm getting distracted. We'll just keep it the way it is. New deal. We gotta watch an ad first, though. These ads always crack me up. Because whoever is playing is really usually pretty bad. I guess maybe I could fast forward through this, can't I? There we go. Okay. Two suits now. We have spades and hearts. This will be a better example of how Spider Solitaire can get a bit tricky at times. So obviously I want to play the hearts on the hearts and the spades on the spades. But then there comes a point where you might not have any more options. In which case, you can start playing the hearts on the spades and the spades on the hearts just to advance the game. So like this 5, I can play on the 6. But then you see, I can't move the 6 now. It's trapped beneath the 5. So that is the drawback. But at least I got a queen out of it. So we're still advancing the game by doing that. It's a lot of eights. Okay. Well, it looks like that's maybe all we can do. So, I'll start with playing cards that go on the same suit. I have 1-6 for the 7, but I have 2-5s that I could play on that 6. So I kind of need to decide which 5 would be better to move onto the 6. It depends what's beneath it. We can make a few other decisions before we get there, though. I'm thinking that it might be better to play this 5, because then we can move this 5 onto the 6 of hearts. We have a pretty good sequence going here and here. We have a 3-2-ace in the middle. Not sure if there's too much more we can do, though. I don't have a queen. Don't have a 9. I don't have a queen. Don't have a 7, a 3. I could move that over there, but it's already on a four. Okay. Nice. We got a red queen on that king. That's perfect. But now my jack through eight is trapped beneath this five. So we're going to have to work around that. You can see it's really starting to get tricky now. Undo. I did not mean to do that. If we could just open up a free spot, maybe we could work something out. Okay. I have a seven here. I have let's see. Oh, here's one way to use a free spot efficiently. I can put the six and five there. Move the 7 onto the 8. And then open up that free spot again. Let's see what else. Let's move the 2 to the 3. The 4 on the 5. There's a 4. I would love to put this 8, 7, 6, and 5 on top of this 9, but they're both stuck at the moment. So that is not possible. I could put the 3 on the 4. Now I have a spot for the 10 at least. Okay, there we go. I could do that. But then I think I'm stuck for now. Should we try to keep going? Okay, let's do it. Over here. We're getting pretty close right here. Spider Solitaire is a lot more studying the cards that you have as opposed to traditional solitaire where you're constantly flipping through new cards. So, for that reason, Spider Solitaire is not, maybe not as exciting to watch, but let me know in the comments what you think. Because I love playing it, but I can understand why watching such a slow game is just not as entertaining. That really sucks. That king just trapped our best stack. Yikes. Let's see what we can do. Was pretty good. 7 through ace in hearts twice. Oh, queen there. I'm thinking maybe I'll put this 5 there. Which 7 would be better to play on that 8? Round. I'm not in the best position. I have 2 tens and 1 jack, so I'm gonna have to figure that out. I don't know which option is best. I'd love to remove this king. So maybe we try to go for this one. Oh yes, exactly. Okay. So I'm pretty sure the best move is to... Well, not so sure actually. I don't see it black. Oh wait. We can access that black queen, so let's, there we go, move the 9 to the 10, borrow an ace, nice, throw the black queen, looks like we're not out of this yet. For now, we can move this to the jack. There's a 7 through 8, so if we could just get a red 8. I see 2 there, 1 there. They're all at the bottom. There we go. Next move, we'll be playing something in that open spot, but I'm just trying to figure out what would be best. Maybe this. I should also preface by saying that I usually allow myself to use the undo button while playing Spider Solitaire. Never in solitaire, traditional solitaire, never. Well, I used to when I was playing on the, the video game on the computer. But, I don't know, especially when you get to 4 suits, I would almost argue that it's nearly impossible to win without using the undo button. Okay. Let's see. Just getting a little organized, that's all. What should we do next? I guess we could do like that. So, as you can see, I think maybe we would have. Actually, I don't think we have to use the undo button just yet. Let's see. Nice. I almost used the undo button, but I'm glad I didn't. One thing I like to do, just for fun, is I like to have the suits alternating over here, if I have the luxury. If I am clearly losing, then I don't care what order they're in. Personal best. And we've scored 100 points. Look at that. Well, now we've won both the single suit and the double suit game. Oh, it's a jigsaw puzzle. Actually might be fun to play. I could play that on the channel. Might be quite relaxing actually. Well, do I want to play another game? I'm not sure. Spiderette. What's Spiderette? Oh, maybe it said 52 cards instead of 104. So it must be like a shortened version of Spider Solitaire. Oh, wow. This is so cute. This looks more like Solitaire, doesn't it? But is it? It's still Spider, I think. Let's try. Well, I don't see any moves. Oh, yeah, of course. Okay, yeah. So this is basically Spider Solitaire, but only with 52 cards. And so I guess for this, you only have 7 spots total. That makes sense. It looks like Solitaire. It's so cute. Just because it's cute doesn't mean that it's going to be any easier. In fact, it might be harder. We have less options to work with. Seems those two kings are lethal. Whoa, that switched things up. Okay, we're not out of it yet. Smart about this. Should we find out what's beneath the five? It's a red four. Okay. I don't know what to do. See what's beneath this five. Black three. No, that's not any better. What if we do king, queen, jack? Have we lost? Yeah, it's telling us we've lost. I'm gonna say don't show this again, though. Okay, I think I quite like Spiderette. Just as a quick game. I say we try it again. Nope. I think the app froze. Solitaire on the iPad. But until then, please remember that you are all kings and queens. Thank you so much for watching.